Public warning. This podcast contains explicit content. Due to the nature of the horror films we are commentarying on, being used for educational purposes, and maybe for entertainment and stuff and things. I'm Chad, and this is Horror Commentary with Jonas and Keith.
So instead of me doing terrible musical impressions, I think we should do authentic scared reactions.
Keith, you have been doing musical impressions probably for the last hour and a half, and I'm going to cut all of it out. And
You want to watch a movie instead?
Well, I mean, the musical impressions were great, but I think we just need to start watching the movie and not have a four-hour podcast.
Yeah, that's chill.
Hey, everyone. Welcome to Horror Commentary.
Hi. Hey.
My name's Jonas.
My name's Keith.
Sometimes he's Frank and I'm Ernest, but we'll let you know when that happens.
But we're never late.
But you can't call us late for dinner because we find you.
And don't anyway. Call me Shirley.
Oh, that's a great reference. Shout out to Airplanes.
So this movie... This is a Guillermo del Toro joint.
Guillermo, do you know who he is?
Guillermo.
I do.
I don't know him personally. I have heard great things. Great guy. Like, means well.
For sure means well.
Means well. Most recent film, as you know, I like to start off the movies with a little bit of trivia. The movie we are watching this week is, drumroll please, Crimson Peak. Crimson Peak, released, was it 2015?
Yeah, last year for sure.
Yep. Crimson Peak went under the working title of Crimson Sneak.
But then the executive producers are like, no one's wearing sneakers, so we got to change that to Peak because everyone's wearing peaked shoes.
Mm-hmm. Guillermo del Toro, how do you pronounce it?
Chad Wixon.
Chad Wixon. Is he Mexican or is he Spanish?
Well, his full name is Chad Wixtonville Nestlehood, but
that was impressive.
Yeah, he thought he'd have to trim it down a bit.
Rodney Winkler Pepperbottom.
It's like Zach Galifianakis. Is that your full name? Well, it's actually Zach Galifianakiston.
Yeah, says the guy with two first names, so I can't trust a word you're saying at this point.
I have three first names.
Well, I don't even care anymore. Why are you in my house? I would like to give a little shout out to anybody who listens. And if you find it funny or you got some sweet horror suggestions, I would say we're really open to that. We've had some good recommendations. And if I'm not mistaken, actually, Crimson Peak today was a suggestion from our number one Jackie Chan and Channing Tatum both recommended Crimson Peak.
Congratulations, Jackie Chan.
You're the winner of a recommendation and a shout out on a podcast you will never watch.
All right. Hit and play in 3, 2, 1, play.
Good cover. And all it's right. Already crimson.
Bit creepy at the beginning, not gonna lie. Mm-hmm. Looks like Armageddon over the Earth.
A little bit.
As the universe...
It's Universe. Get right. Dude, you get to sit through these movies with me. You don't even have a chance. I find me annoying. I can't imagine what it's like for you on the outside.
Come in from the outside, just as you want. All right, this is legendary.
Wait for it.
So that's Guillermo tooting his own horn, saying this is already a legendary movie.
That's a little arrogant.
Bit rude. Bit early to say that.
Whoa.
Okay, we're looking at a chick with a hand. Oh, that's Alice from Alice in Wonderland.
Oh, is it?
She's all bloody, has cuts on her face.
Her hair is blonde.
She's from Alice in Wonderland, sorry?
That's Alice.
Wow, she got lost, eh?
Yeah, she re-lost.
She went through that rabbit hole.
What'd she say? This much I know. Oh, okay, now got a couple guys. It's winter out.
The first
A couple guys are carrying a coffin.
Really cool looking
Can
hats.
Can I ask you to just give this some greasy chicken in volume?
I hate how you like volume on these things. I'm scared.
The only thing is, otherwise people can't hear. Oh, okay, so she's going back in time. We're looking at a picture of a little her.
Yeah, that's a young Alice.
They're putting someone in the ground.
As There's you
a,
do.
They're at a, we're at a funeral. I'm going to tell everyone right now that what she is saying is important.
Her hat kind of looks like a cupcake wrapper.
That's a bit rude, but I'd say accurate. All right, now we're in a creepy house. At night, it's thundering and raining.
Oh, she's sad.
It's her as a little girl. And she's very sad. I don't think she's creeped out. I think she's just sad. She has frillies on her nightgown.
Like I say, cupcake wrappers.
Keith, do you have any idea how annoying that would be?
That would be delicious.
Cupcake wrappers around your neck as you try to sleep? What was that? Oh, it's her, is it her breathing or is that like a door?
Mm-hmm.
All right, she's covering her mouth. She's looking over. Did the door open? Oh, frick.
What?
There's like shadowed hands down the hallway. Holy.
Oh my gosh.
A freaky thing in a dress just started walking down the hallway towards her. You can see through it.
What are you doing? Call Ghostbusters.
Gross mustard. It's now in her room. It's getting closer. She's. Oh, I just put her hand on her. Now it's lying down on the bed beside her. Saying something about Crimson Peak. Girl screams, gets up, and it's gone. She gets out of bed. She starts walking towards the hallway.
It would be years before I again heard such a voice.
Whoa. Sweet melodies of the prophets.
Well, that was that was quite the intro.
Those hands in the shadow.
Yeah, that was creepy.
That was dung fudged up, son. Moths, Guillermo. Guillermo loves moths. Crimson Peak, everybody. Crimson Peak.
So I like to think of what I would do in these situations. And if a ghost said Crimson Peak, guess where I'm not going.
You're not going anywhere with Crimson or Peaks.
No, Kay. Buffalo's fine.
Buffalo, New York, 14 years later. Yeah. We live close to Buffalo.
We do. A big fan of their wings.
Yeah, yeah. All right, so we're in, what year is it?
I didn't
probably look. 18, I don't think we know. 18-something.
1990 in Peterborough.
Okay, so we're following Alice. She's running through the mud. We're in Buffalo, by the way. She looks happy. This is 15 years later. She's not worried about creepy ghosts. She's in a building running up some stairs. Oh, there's a boy who notices her. Edith.
Alan, when did you get back?
Hey, Alan.
I thought Eunice had told you.
No, I hadn't heard.
It's Pacific Rim.
He's from Pacific Rim?
Specifically, yeah. He's from a specific rim, for sure.
Guess what they're doing, everyone? You're not going to be able to guess. They're flirting. He wants her to come and visit. Oh, Alan's mother came down the stairs. She doesn't like Alice. Ooh, Alice is uncomfortable. Ooh, his mom? Is a word that rhymes with a witch.
Actually, Mrs. McMichael, I would prefer to be married.
A stitch.
Oh, okay.
She's very tiny.
Okay. My goodness, I'm sitting here just quaking in my boots. Not because the movie's scary, but just those colors. They didn't go with anything.
No, and they're wearing all those colors after Labor Day. All right, she's writing a letter. Oh, she got ink on her hands and therefore all over her face. Oh, that's the dad in Jumanji.
Yeah, Jim?
Jim Bob? Is it Jim Bob?
Jim? Is this Jumanji?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we accidentally put on Jumanji. Father didn't tell me. What a great movie, though. Jumanji terrified me as a kid.
Yeah, big time.
I had nightmares.
The plants.
The spiders. Spiders the size of your guitar over there.
Don't talk to me about spiders the size of my guitar. Freaking me out.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you're not going to believe this. Why do I keep saying that? Alice and her father had a conversation that I heard nothing of. Oh, there's another guy eating dinner at the dining room. She comes in, gives him a peck on the cheek. He gives her a gift.
It's an E-pen. She vapes.
Yo, Alice vapes, son.
It's lit.
I saw a tweet today that was like a parent listening to their child, and the child is like, yo, fam, that's lit. Yo, tell Bay that squad dog fleek. Parent dials 911. I think my son had a seizure. It's so true. We talk really weird nowadays.
No, they do.
Fam, it's lit. Bay? All right. Oh, there's Loki.
It's Loki.
All right.
And so far from Asgard. I have an appointment with Mr. Carter Everett Cushing.
Goodness, with the great man himself. I'm afraid so. He hands her a card. Okay, so Alice is at her job. I guess she's a secretary. Secretary.
Office professional.
Yes, sir. Office professional. And we're not assuming her gender either, are we?
Well, no, that's the point.
Okay.
Because
she is a woman. She is a strong, independent woman.
Could yet to be seen. We don't know whether she's got crimson peaks or...
Well, she's wearing Harry Potter glasses, yeah? She's probably going to... Dovrook and Vrodra.
Can you tell me how to get to Diagon Alley?
Did he just say Diagon Alley? All right, so...
Terrifying movie so far.
Yeah, I'm super beside myself in fear. Loki believes in ghosts. She does not. Now that gentleman that was having dinner must obviously... Oh, that's his daughter.
Well, if you stop talking, you can figure that out. You're hammered.
All right, so Loki is doing a presentation in front of all the big, big chiefs of this company. Oh, crimson. Okay, so he's an inventor, and he deals with clay. Alice just snuck into the room. Oh, Grandpappy said turn it off. Loki is a little bit. Full scale. Not yet, sir. We're very close, but we hope that with funding. So actually, what you have is a toy and some fancy words. Oh. That is. And failed to raise capital in London, Edinburgh. So he is. He's openly mocking him in front of. The father is openly mocking Loki. Whoa. Shadow just went across your door.
That's fine. That's just the ghost from the beginning. She got lost.
Oh, okay.
Did I just see a whiteboard?
Yep. Yes, Charles. Very good. He's touching Loki's hands. You've got the softest hands I've ever felt. That is... In America, we bank on effort, not privilege. That is... Well, that died quickly.
That was nice. I'm here with all I possess, sir. A name, a patch of land, and the will to make it yield. The least that you can grant me is the courtesy of your time. And the chance to prove to you and these fine gentlemen that my will, dear sir, is the very least as strong as yours. Oh, he's a good talker.
Oh,
that was decent.
Yeah, he's a good talker. All right, it's late at night. It's raining something fearsome. We're lighting the candles outside.
He's going to die.
He's wearing his dinner jacket.
He's going to die.
I watched Downton Abbey. I did. Mm-hmm. I finished it.
Downtown?
Downtown in the Abbey. Mm. Right?
Yeah, something like that. From what I hear.
All right, Alice is putting his bow tie. She is trying to convince him that Loki is a good man. I'm hoping that's what she's saying. I can't hear over my talking.
First step is admitting you have a problem.
Probably he's British and he's British. Racist.
He's incredibly racist. He dated Taylor Swift.
This old guy did?
Tom Hiddleston. Not the old guy, although at this point the jury's out.
Who hasn't she dated?
Me? But that's cool. I'm in a committed relationship. I wouldn't want that. Did I cover that well?
Yeah. Alright. They're going down the stairs having small chit chats. Probably to invite a guest in for dinner. Who's their guest?
It's him.
No, that's
Charlie Hunnam.
No, that's Bell Clark from the beginning, and who had the witch for a mother.
Yeah, but his name is Charlie Hunnam. He's from Pacific Rim.
Oh, his name's Charlie.
No, that's the actor. Try to keep up.
No, so his name is Charlie?
The actor is.
Oh, that's okay. I'm okay with calling him Charlie. Yeah, I call Jessica Chastain Jessica Chastain.
Oh, that's not Jessica Chastain.
No, that's Alice. Alice in Wonderland.
I thought that was Pacific. Wow, we are gibbled.
All right, so back to the movie. We are watching Forrest Gump. This is when Forrest is trying to...
The poofiest of
Jenny. Yeah. Trying to tell Jenny he loves her. I love you, Jenny.
All right. Alice has a book. It's Cumberland.
Father, did you get something?
Someone opened the door, but guess what? It's not her father. Oh, the door handle is kind of going a little freaky. Like someone's trying to turn it. She is a little bit concerned.
Yeah, wouldn't you?
She takes her glasses off. She's looking very concerned at the door. The door opens. The doorknob is still freaking out.
Whoa.
Nothing is there. This is probably the ghost from the beginning. Door swings completely
open. This is the ghost.
Call you gross mustard.
I don't understand these people. Ian, this happens. You go the other direction.
No, she is curious.
No, she's
an idiot. Walking towards the door.
Curiosity killed the cat, remember? I haven't seen Garfield for days.
For gays?
No, for days.
Oh.
Wow.
Okay. She touched. She goes to touch the doorknob and the doorknob moves. She goes to close the door, but before she slams it, she stops and looks, and there's the creepy ghost.
Hello.
It puts its arms out and screams at her. She throws the door closed.
Dude, it's a ghost. I'm sure
she puts her ear to the door. She's listening.
I'm over this. This is one of the dumbest people.
She has her hand on the doorknob.
Oh, she's probably gone.
She's talking to the ghost on the other side of the door. The only way you're going to know is if you open the door. Oh! Ghost. The ghost comes through the door, grabs her, and says, "Beware of Crimson Peak." And then she falls back, the door opens, and it's one of the maids.
There are some shadows happening in my living room, though, or my kitchen, though.
That's what I'm saying. I think either someone's walking in front of your door. I'm a little freaked out. It's pretty dark. I would appreciate it. There's Loki sitting in the entrance of their house. I kind of wish you had to put the candle on in there.
Yeah, let's get a flickering flame. You're just as bad as the people in these movies. Shoot. That's romantic.
He is a good looking man.
He's decent.
Oh man, he's
a hard six.
He's a what? I'm sorry.
He's a hard 6 out of 10.
Oh, at a 2, he's a strong 2.
He's a hard 2.
All right, so Loki and her are talking and flirting.
Oh.
Is he inviting her somewhere?
He's inviting himself in.
They're going to do the bad stuff, so if they do.
This is kind of a neat, it's almost like a period piece. No, like they'll clean up.
Oh, okay. Eek.
Yikes.
Eek,
the Crimson Peak.
All right, so now we're at like a ball, and we have some lady wearing a crimson dress, playing the piano in front of everyone, reading sheet music. Oh, it's Jessica Chastain!
No, it's not. She's not ginger. It can't be her.
That chick's ginger. That chick's ginger. That chick's ginger.
There's a lot of gingers.
Oh, Tom Hiddleston and Alice walk into the party. And they look dashing.
He found a sacrifice. She's pale. She needs to tan.
Oh, she's Alice, dude. She's been stuck in a rabbit hole for years.
That's fair. Not a lot of vitamin D.
She is introducing Loki to Jessica Chastain and what was his name? Clarence?
Chuck.
Chuck.
Yeah, Chuck D.
The guy at the beginning who likes Alice. This is Lady Lucille. Lady Lucille.
Oh!
So Jessica Chastain and Loki are brother and sister.
Yeah. And weird, because they kissed.
Yes.
That was a little too Leia.
I saw a little bit of tongue. Who's their inspiration? Luke and Leia? Am I right?
That was just...
All right. The guy's angry mother... Just make an announcement.
Oh, wow.
Oh, man. I would give her a strong talking to.
I'd write her a letter.
All right. We're rearranging the room?
Are they going to dance? Taylor Swift.
Okay. Loki's giving them rules for dancing. They're in like a ballroom. I should just say there's like 100 people in this room. Oh, Loki goes up and asks if Alice would be her partner, and she said, "I don't think so, thank you." Eunice would be delighted. He doesn't want Eunice. He wants Alice.
Who's a kid Eunice?
Probably like someone who's into the opiums.
Yeah, the right? Opioids. All right, so let's see how Tom Hiddleston here can dance with the stars.
Oh, Jessica's going to play the piano. Oh, she's not impressed. Oh, she's not impressed with Alice. Oh, she's very good at the piano. All right, so the goal here is to dance without extinguishing the candle.
Yeah.
I
always
close my eyes to things that make me uncomfortable. Oh. It makes everything easier. I don't want to close my eyes. She doesn't want to close her eyes.
I don't want to close my eyes. I don't want to fall asleep because you're scary, baby. Oh.
All right. The candle. They're dancing hard. Like, have you seen Never Back Down 3? Or what's the Save the Last Dance, whatever it's called?
Those are... Wow. Your references tonight are inexplicable.
No, but what's like that break dance? Because they are step going... Step up to the microphone. They, like, cardboard is
step
laid.
Step up to the mic.
The cardboard is down, and Loki and Alice are just shredding it right now. But the candle is not going out.
No, because the flame between them, that's their love.
The flame is their love.
Mm-hmm.
Look at your finger on the red light. It shows like your bone.
It's my crimson peak.
All right, they did it. Everyone's clapping. The candle is still going. Jessica looks back at her.
She's not happy.
No, she does not like her. Whoa. Oh, she's smiling and just to be nice.
So she keeps covering her hand.
Her father looks at Jessica, who left, back to Alice.
Don't you think you'd have wax on your hand?
Probably. Loki and Alice smiled at each other. and blew up the candle.
Oh my.
Next, new scene. Oh, this guy.
Oh yeah, he's from
He's from Dark Knight Rises.
And he's from Pacific Rim.
Get out. Mm-hmm. Oh, Del Toro did Pacific Rim, didn't he?
Big time.
Oh, okay, yeah. I forgot that.
There's a young gentleman and his sister. I want you to investigate for me. Something not quite right about that. I want results as soon as possible.
What was he's just an informant?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
A spy of some sort.
Papa just gave an informant a letter and said, I want results as soon as possible.
Oh, he's an eye doctor.
Oh, so Chuck is an eye doctor.
Chucky bye.
Who's this? Alice? Is she drinking? Oh, no, she has glasses. She's reading books in Chuck's library.
Who taught her to read?
Probably a redhead who changed their hair color.
Yeah, Jessica Chastain. Taint.
Ooh! Probably accurate. Okay, so we're pulling blinds on skylights. All right, I just need to watch this for a second to see if I can figure out what's happening. Oh. All right, so he's pulling out photographs, and he's talking about latent images. And the one picture he has on has two women sitting in the picture, and then just lightly in the background, there is a demon.
There's a ghost. How creepy is that?
Dude, these kind of pictures freak me out.
That man will never perceive the colors red or green. He only accepts their existence because the majority around him does.
Who? Ooh.
Okay, that's stupid.
No, I'm going to put that on a t-shirt.
Now go back to class. Look at her.
She's never spoken to me about these interests of yours, Alan. She's never given me the chance.
He's just trying to impress her. Oh, boy.
Oh, that looks like the thing from It Follows. It followed her here.
The 9-foot guy?
Yeah, big time.
I didn't like him.
No, he was...
He was full of badness.
Someone say he was... Ooh.
Ooh, that picture's not looking too good. Looks a little grainy. I guess this is... Fast forward to the future a bit. Loki and Alice are...
Yeah, maybe the future by like one day.
Oh.
Oh, sweet. John Lennon glasses there, bud. So yeah. Tom Hiddleston is now rocking the fashionable outfits. Oh, wait. What's this?
Okay, yeah. It looks like... Okay. Oof. No. Jessica Chastain just cut something out of a tree... Oh, a cocoon. She cut a cocoon out of a tree. And they kneeled down on the grass, Alice and Jessica. And there's a bunch of butterflies, beautiful butterflies. They're just dying. She's going to eat it.
Beautiful things are fragile. That was interesting. Whoa. What is this guy's obsession with Mothman? Maybe he was the dude who did the Mothman prophecies.
He's Spanish. Spanish people love moths.
Oh, they do.
They like to eat them in their stews. Oh, there's a butterfly on the ground and all the ants. Please don't tell me the thing's still alive.
The ants are eating away at the butterfly.
Yeah, and we are getting... Oh! Okay. Oh, that was dang fudged up. It was a close-up of the ants chewing away at the butterfly's eyes.
Ooh.
Jessica and Loki are talking. And what did she say? She's not...
Hold on.
Loki needs a ring that Jessica has. Okay, that's a bit confusing.
Yeah.
What do they say about it? She's not ready or she's too young or
she's
something?
She's too young and then he needs the ring from her for something.
Yeah, so Loki needed... Jessica and Loki were talking about Alice and Jessica's saying she's too young. And Loki's like, I need this ring because I need to sell it or something. And she's like, we're not selling it. We're going to be buying something. So I don't know what that means. Probably going to figure it out later. Loki wants to have a word with her. Oh, he has the ring. He's going to propose. Loki's going to propose.
No, he's not going to propose. He's just, it's the one ring.
Frodo.
Miss Kirsten. I really have no right to ask this, but...
So, Thomas, may I speak with you in my study, please?
Oh.
And your sister, if you would be so kind as to fetch her.
Loki was just about to propose, or something. And her father came around the corner and was like, I need to talk to you and your sister in my study.
Sir Thomas, the first time we met, I imagine it was hard for you to realize that I didn't like you.
You made that clear enough, sir. I had hoped that now, with time...
Sir Thomas, is up.
Could you speak plainly, Mr. Cushing?
Jessica says speak plainly.
Plainer than you might like to hear. In the past few days, your brother has deemed it fine enough business with pleasure by repeatedly engaging socially with my daughter. My only daughter.
Sir, I'm aware that I have no position to offer, but the fact is, you are falling in love with her.
Oh!
Is that it?
You play the part well.
Loki's falling in love with her.
The other day, my daughter asked me why I didn't like you.
Why don't you like him?
Honestly, at the time, I had no good answer.
He had no good answer.
Now I do.
He does now. He has a document that probably the spy guy found.
The first honest reaction I've seen from you.
Uh-oh.
Does she know?
No. But I will tell her if that's what it takes to send you on your way.
Sir, I know you will find this hard to believe.
You love her. I know. You're repeating yourself. Now you.
He just wrote something.
More collected one day.
On a check? All right, he handed them a check and said,
tonight you must thoroughly break her heart.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, so he gave them a check. Basically, do they pay them off? And he's like, this check will clear on two conditions. One, there's a train leaving. Make sure you're on it. And two, you need to thoroughly break my daughter's heart.
Ooh, I think this might be the point where he thoroughly breaks her heart.
What, is he Irish? Hey, Loki's giving a speech in front of everyone.
My heart was brimming with a sense of adventure. Here, the future actually seemed to mean something.
There's a lot of dialogue in this, people.
Friendship among you all, but for now, farewell.
Farewell, he's saying farewell.
Maybe meet again.
Oh, he almost touched her boob.
Perhaps on a different show.
This is sad, man.
My sister and I depart for England.
A father put his hand on Alice's shoulder and almost missed. And in Loki's speech, he's like, we're leaving for wherever. Alice is very sad.
Edith.
And...
And
left the room. Father said, go after her.
Hold us in America.
I see.
Your novel. I read the new chapters. I'll have them delivered in the morning.
That's very good of you. Thank you.
Would you still like to know my thoughts?
If we must.
I'm pregnant.
It's absurdly sentimental. The aches that you describe with such earnestness. The pain. The loss. You clearly haven't lived at all. In fact, you only seem to know what other writers tell you.
That's enough.
You insist on describing...
Oh, he's talking about the book she wrote, and she's letting him read. And he has just given it to her about how stupid it is.
A pure soul to be redeemed. A wounded bird you can nourish. Affection. Affection has no place in love, Edith. I advise you to return to your ghosts and fancies. The sooner the better. You know precious little of the human heart. Or love.
There's people that have entered the room. Oh, she hit him! Like, everyone's in the room. Why do they all come in to witness that? Loki looks at the father. The father's like, well, you done broke her heart.
Well, you did what I asked, and I can't believe that it cost that much, but, hey, not.
There's Jessica.
Job.
What is with these weird transitions?
Guillermo actually ran out on his Final Cut budget and basically cut this with Windows Movie Maker. Oh, here we are back in the shave scene.
Yeah, we're back in the showers and Grandpappy is, he's getting ready to shave, even though he has a big old nasty beard.
Big old nasty beard.
What time is it?
Oh, he's gonna die here, man.
Yeah. Oh, I shave the top of the beard. I shave there too.
Oh, you got it. You gotta take. You gotta get your cheeks good.
Oh, he's just about to shave. He heard a noise.
Yeah, he's dead.
Oh, he put the knife down on the sink. The sink's ready to overflow. He wipes the shaving cream off. Well, he looks to the right, and there is a shadow that went by.
Whoa, what's... Oh, is that marble wall or blood?
I think that's a marble wall.
I like marble cheese.
I like playing marbles, like when I was a kid.
Oh, marbles. Marblies.
Yeah. I don't know if it's evident, but when I was a kid, I definitely lost
my marbles. Okay, guys, get ready.
All right.
This is a Guillermo trademark.
He's looking around. He's hearing noises. Oh, his sink is done overflowing. The knife falls off the sink. He's walking over towards the sink to turn off the taps. He reaches out, turns them, bends down, picks up the knife.
And then?
Stands up, and there's someone behind him with gloves. Who is it? Oh!
Oh.
Holy! Oh! Oh! Ah. What? Okay, so the person is smashing his facing on the sink. And ladies and gentlemen, this is very graphic. I was not expecting that.
I saw it coming.
Not that graphic. That was done fricked up. We just watched Commandingus. It was like Pan's Labyrinth. Do you remember when the sergeant takes the bottle and smashes the father's nose in? Ooh, and you watch it like with every hit?
Yeah.
That Guillermo has a dark side. All right. Next morning, look at all the dust in the air. Alice was sleeping, but there's letters for her. Oh, I wonder who the letter could be from.
Flatbook says that the letter is like MapQuest directions to Crimson Peak.
Probably, right? She puts her Harry Potter glasses on. She reaches down. She's hesitant. She grabs the letter.
She opens it up, and it's acceptance to Hogwarts.
It's Loki.
Your father made evident to me that in my present economic condition, I was not in a position to provide for you, and to this I agreed.
Annie?
He also asked Loki, me to break your heart.
Loki told her everything, that her father made him do it.
So she still doesn't know that her dad just, like, went toe-to-toe headbutt in the sink.
Nope. She ran to the hotel, asked for Loki and his sister. The receptionist told her where they are, and then he's like, no, wait. They've already left. She missed them. Her stomach is queasy. Her heart's so broken.
Morning sickness, bro.
She's mad Praggers.
Just Praggers. Praggers with an egger.
Right. Takes off. Oh, she's an actual person. She's not Harry Potter when she takes
off. It's hard to say.
Oh. Oh, he's there. She comes out of the room, and there he's standing. He walked up. He said, your father bribed me to leave. This is a love story, Keith.
No, it's not.
You better snuggle in close to me, buddy.
I'm just wondering why are your pants just like that. You know what I mean? And by that, I mean like jorts that aren't on.
Well, sometimes you need to air yourself out.
Yikes.
All right. He's talking very passionately to her how much he loves her.
I hate his eyebrows, though, eh?
I do. I like them. I mean, I like his eyebrows. He's got a nice face. I don't like her. I'm going to throw...
Oh, dude, I hate her.
She is not one of my favorite actresses. And they're kissing. Oh, wait. No, okay, oh, now they are.
Wow, it's their first kiss.
Yeah, she's definitely never kissed anyone before. I don't want to sound rude, Keith.
Please do.
She is not my favorite actress. And personal preference, I don't think she's that good looking. I think a paper bag would be more...
Wow.
would be appropriate headwear
well,
for
her. Well, it's accurate because it's pretty well what she's been wearing this whole time.
Oh, okay, she walks out. There's a dude. Oh, one of the dudes in her father's council walks up to her, takes his hat off, and he has a concerned look.
Under one of these blankets is your father.
Now they're
if
in...
If you guessed correctly, you win...
Tape.
Signed.
Now they're in the morgue. Her and Loki. Someone just said, wait. It's Chuck. He came as soon as he heard. I'm here. He always says, don't look at him. It was Chuck.
No, Chuck was Chuck.
No, dude, it was Chuck. How would he know? They don't know. He said, don't look at him. Because he knows his face is done fudged up.
Are you ready for something
Alice
gruesome?
Is pulling back the sheets. Oh, it's horrific. And she can't bear to look.
Yeah, he tripped and he fell and he hit a sink. So that
she's
sucks.
Crying. She's a good crier.
Oh, of course. Look at her. Like, come on.
She has tears coming out of her face. Chuck, oh, right, because he's a doctor.
Because then Chuck looks at him and he's
Chuck
like...
Chuck is all
oh
in
Oh, my
there.
Gosh. He's dead.
Chuck is poking his fingers and cavities in that guy's head where there shouldn't be cavities. Don't touch him like that.
Stop, don't
touch him like that.
That's my father.
Forgive me, Alice.
He's turning 60 next week.
Oh,
yeah.
Frick.
He's looking his age, you see. He likes to keep
on walks. Alice, he's gone. Because he's gone,
because
Alice.
Because he's dead.
She put his hand under the sheet to keep it warm. Yeah, well, how old do you think she is? She's probably very young. Doesn't have much...
I would say early 20s.
Early, oh, really? Yeah. I would probably say like 18 or 19.
Oh, look, now we're back to this other one. So this is probably the beginning of act, like, three, whatever.
All right, we're back at the cemetery. Except this time she's with Loki. And she's much older and now burying her father. So almost being her mother.
And this in Pacific Rim over there, he just nodded at Loki. Maybe they know something.
And it pans down from her face to her hand on Loki's breast, and she's wearing the ring. All right.
The ring.
Glory shot of Cumberland, England.
Allerdale Hall, also known as...
Crimson Peak. Wow,
it's
that's
got a
kind
five-star
of a...
rating on bedandbreakfasts.com.
Two-star on Yelp.
Yeah, wouldn't you want to go to... Come to Crimson Peak. There's only one ghost. 2 stars.
I think they filmed this in PEI.
Are you lying?
Look at the sand, bud.
There's... I love a PEI potato. Hearts, stars, and horseshoes.
The red sand.
There's other places with red sand.
I don't know one other place in the world. Name
Montana.
One other place.
Montana.
Don't think so. All right, there's a puppy.
That's because your dad was missing his head.
He didn't... Oh... Touche, Keith.
Of course.
I'm waiting for the creepy deekies, but we're 45 minutes ish into this, and there's only been a couple creepy deekies.
Are you sure this was a horror movie? Because this to me is seeming like a gothic romance that's a shot for shot remake of The Sound of Music.
I don't think it's The Sound of Music. I think you mean The End of the Sixth Happiness.
Oh, yeah, this is the house you want to go to. Oh, look, the dog's already running to get cooked in the fire.
Look at the stuff falling from the leaves. What's she counting, leaves? That's a beautiful place, though.
Yeah.
I would live there, for sure, by myself in a thunderstorm. Nah. It's even colder inside than out. All right, so Loki's, they're just in the front hall of Crimson Peak House. There's definitely a boo-boo in the top of the house that's made it completely open. Oh!
That makes sense, though. That's it's red mud.
Yeah, so he stepped on the floorboard in the middle of the floor.
And ketchup came out.
And, yeah, it looked like red, dirty, bloody sand juiced through it.
Ew.
Yeah. Oh, he's going to show her around.
Yeah, I can't wait to show you the hole in the beginning. Or the beginning, wow.
Well, Keith, what just are you pickled. Trying to say? All right, she goes up to a mirror. She removes her veil. Unclips her... Oh, she took a pin out and it made a very swordy zing sound.
Yeah, that was the master sword.
Now the camera's panning down. It's gone. Wait, no, those are dead bugs. They're starting to move again. Nope. They died.
No, they're chilling.
Oh, she looked in the mirror, and there's a figure.
Yeah, it's her sister.
Remember? Kind of hobbling, a shadowy creature, hobbling along somewhere. There's a fire going.
A roaring fire.
A roaring.
Fit for a king.
Rory. Oh, they have an elevator in this place.
As you do. A dumb waiter, if you will.
So she's just kind of looking... Oof, the rock is gross. She's just looking around. Oh, there's a puppy.
She gets distracted so easily.
Oh, the puppy brought a ball. She says, where'd you get this ball?
I saw a woman in the elevator. A woman? You mean Lucille? No, it wasn't Lucille.
Must have been a shadow. She's telling Loki, saw someone in the elevator. He's like, my sister? And she said, no. He says, never, ever go below this level. Oh, there's his sister. Just came in the kitchen. Or came in the room with them. They're in the kitchen. She looks at her. Jessica. Oh, she welcomes Alice.
I'm at the post office. Your machine parts are here from Birmingham. And they couldn't have touched
them. I think Loki killed him.
No. He wouldn't do that.
He's Loki. He's the king of trickster. Or the god of tricks.
That's fine. That's fine, though.
That's not fine, Keith.
Well, have you ever had tricks? They're the most delicious.
Hat tricks?
No tricks. Like the fruity cereal.
Silly rabbit, tricks are for kids. You shall.
You shall now.
Jessica talks about the ring. Oh, their bride. She's his bride. I guess that makes sense, but no, there was no wedding.
I love all the copper pots, though.
I love all the things.
Can you wake up? See, that's not a good sign.
No, this is a bad sign, Keith. I'm actually worried.
Like,
I think this may not...
What did she say?
All right, said something. Alice smiled, walked off. Oh, Jessica... Ooh, Jessica.
You're never going to get my keys.
Grabs onto her keys and holds on tightly as if someone's trying to steal it. All right, Keith, I think this is where shite hits the fan. I think this is a 2-hour movie.
Oh.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, perfect. Oh, there you go.
There's like bloody water coming out of the tap.
It's Crimson Bench. She's peeking.
Oh, and the water's flooding now.
Oh.
Bing, bong, bing, bong, bing. All right, I think they're making some tea. Keith, they're making a evening cuppa.
Why are you getting close to me?
I'm getting scared and I need to be cuddled.
I ain't giving
Keith,
you nothing.
I have been without my wife for a week now.
And
I
you
need
choose,
to be
no,
cuddled.
No, you choose your words very carefully going forward after a statement like that.
I need to be cuddled.
I'm getting water on. I'm out.
All right, Loki and his sister had a very important conversation in which I missed. All right, Alice is in the tub.
See, she doesn't even know how to take a bath. This woman is just...
She's not bathing. She's just sitting there looking around, freaked out. Oh, she threw the ball for the puppy.
The dog is going to come back as a cat. Do you remember that show, Cat Dog?
No. Do you remember Sharky and George? Crime Busters of the Sea?
No.
Okay. All right. She's just throwing the ball for the dog. This looks oddly similar to how her bedroom was. It's a long, narrow room.
When did you see your bedroom?
At the beginning.
I know you haven't seen your wife in a while, but like, bud, dial her back, big rig.
What?
What?
We saw her bedroom at the beginning. And the creepy... Oh, no. Oh, frick, Keith.
What?
Okay, she's looking down the hallway, and this, like, crinkly, creaky thing just peeked around the corner down the hallway.
Yeah, it was the Babadook.
Babadook, dook, dook. All right. Alice gets out of the tub. She puts her house coat on. Holy frick, you can see behind her, and it's a misty, very glitchy thing.
Oh, that's the crimson.
In all red. We're looking at it right now. Alice can't see it because she's turned around.
You know who that reminds me of?
Frick, look at the hands. Oh, it's missing a finger. Oh my gosh. It's like red dyed skin, but you can see inside the skull. It's all skeletal. And its hand was reaching out for her at the doorway. Alice turned around, and it's gone. Here's a puppy again. Hey, puppy.
Can you imagine the puppy just goes right through the ghost and goes like, shh, I'm sneaking up. Don't go, go, go.
Oh, frick. She's saying, where's the ball? Where's the ball? And she's petting the dog.
See, there's my ball.
And then the ball.
Ball
rolls in from down the hall. Keith, I'm hungry.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
Oh, you should eat something then. Idiot. I can eat something. I'm sorry, that was aggressive.
Keith, that was very rude.
Do you want to order a pizza?
No.
Yeah, because I can't eat that.
Okay, so Tom comes in. Tom. Well, it's Tom. Loki.
No, his name is Tom.
I know, and his name's Thomas in the movie.
Tom squared. Tom.
He comes in and brings her a cup of tea. He does something with the fire, and then a big whooshing noise happens. She runs up, hugs him, and says, what is that?
When it picks up the chimneys form a vacuum.
He says it's the wind in the chimneys.
Breeze. It's ghastly, I know.
He says this house breathes. Ghastly, I know.
Now, remember, though, at the beginning, when he first met her, and they were talking about ghosts, he said, I believe that ghosts are not something to be trifled with, or something like that.
Oh. And then there's Jessica Chastain peeking in through the keyhole.
Jessica Chastain.
Oh, boy.
And then here's Edith.
Edith?
Have you ever noticed that it's whenever she's in a bed?
She woke up and she's beside Loki. Oh, because they're married.
Oh, yeah, they're married now. That's true. But have you noticed that whether she's in the bed or whether she's in a tub or whether she's in an autopsy room,
she looks freaking creepy.
And it's like it's the first time she's ever been there.
Yeah.
It's she's like, oh, a balcony.
She's like a newborn baby stairs. Chicken everywhere she goes.
She's a newborn baby chicken.
All right. So she is walking. She walked down all the stairs. She's in the main lobby. She hears the piano. Here's Jessica playing the piano. It's beautiful. This house is beautiful, but creepy AF.
What does that mean?
Jessica's telling us.
What is it?
It's Don't Drop That Dantana by Young Jeezy.
This is Jay-Z's new single.
Nursery.
In the attic. Oh, there's a big picture of Mother, and guess what? Mother looks creepy.
That's how
you. And there's the ring. Alice notices they have the same ring.
Mother. Ooh. Looks quite horrible.
Oh, Jessica said it. They're just looking at the picture, talking about how horrible Mother was.
So now the ghost of the mom is listening to her kid and some random girl just talk major smack on them. Just like, oh, look how horrible you are. And then she's just, man, that was a bad hair day. That was the picture you took.
They say painters add 10 pounds on you.
How many painters did you eat?
Oh!
Ooh, look at that.
Oh, boy. A book on love.
That's a love book.
Oh! There needs to be an heir.
Why?
She just gave her a book on the hinky kinky.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, he was very nice to me in the morning. We haven't done the hanky panky.
Mm. Yeah, and that then was
Jessica was like, so that means that they need the hanky panky to happen.
So all this right, guy, Pacific Chuck. Rim.
Chuck.
Chucky boy. Chuck Billy Totem Pole.
I don't like his hair. Grow a beard and maybe we'll talk. Oh. So Chuck's in the at the desk. He found the father's checkbook. He's figuring it out. Now he's in the washroom where the father died, and he's looking at the sink. The
father got like brained on that thing.
Yeah, but the sink looked like, was it repaired before? Or was he just reminiscing on a new sink that
he... See, like, once again, the first time that I ever threw a ball for a tiny little rat-shaped cat.
Yeah, Alice was throwing a ball for the dog outside, and now Alice is back in the house. She's in the elevator, getting out of the elevator.
How would you classify this movie right now?
Dog.
Would you call it horror?
As... I mean, it's had ghosts, and I've been scared a couple times. Like I said, okay, we go into a room, and it's full of moths and butterflies.
Freaking moths. Just invest in a mothball.
Oh, and those are totally CG, too. CG, too. Oh, frick, Alice is hearing, like, wailing.
Yeah, wouldn't you, though?
No, I wouldn't, Keith, because I wouldn't go up there. Ooh. Wheelchair's gonna move. She walked by a wheelchair.
Oh, she's sitting there.
Oh, yeah, you can see. There's a ghostly figure that kind of appeared on the chair. I think that this is a 2-hour movie.
Mm.
We're at the 1-hour mark right now.
Yeah.
Then the last hour is going to be Mama.
Well, whatever. It better get that good.
I'm really hoping it does, because it's a great story and all, I would imagine.
This woman just frustrates me to no end.
I haven't really been watching this in regards of catching the story. I'm trying to get scared. So far, I've only been scared twice.
Well, of course.
That's a bit creepy.
This one's a bone.
Oh, it's got two faces. So she goes in, she finds Loki working away, and we just found out that Loki makes little creepy toys.
She's the... Dude, look at her. She's...
He loves her.
You know what is that I don't like about her now?
Oh! He's looking at her like...
So I'll answer my own question.
Sorry. What's going on?
I'm saying I...
Oh, hey, everyone. Keith's here. Everyone say hey to Keith. She kisses him. She kisses Keith. I mean, Loki.
That's not Loki.
Keith, what? Oh my gosh, they're using each other's heads as tongue depressors.
Ew, they're Keith, snogging.
A right proper snog. He's trying to take her dress off.
It just...
Ooh.
For me, man, I don't like her because she just seems dumb. She just seems really stupid.
They stopped because they heard a noise. Sure enough, they were about to get the hanky-panky on, but Jessica comes in with tea. Loki looks at her like...
Yeah, like, thanks for blocking me.
Yeah. Like, it's so cold, there's a couple things in here that are blue.
Yeah, big time. Oh.
Oh. Okay, Alice was the only one who drank from the tea, and then she is awoken in the middle of the night, startled.
See, once again, it's like this is the first time she woke up. Tom is a pillow.
Loki isn't there. Dog's there, obviously. She's walking around with creepy candles. She has very long, gangly, strangly hair.
Well, she's just a gangly actress. What do you expect?
Keith! All right, she heard something from behind her. A door opens. Oh, she goes towards
this dog is about to get sushied.
Keith, this is when we're going to see some Del Toro mama.
You're not going to see nothing.
All right, she walks out onto the balcony in the main entrance.
Who leaves the fire burning all night?
Keith, it gets cold. You have to.
Well, I don't know these things. That's not like the advent of HVAC just happened.
All right, she's
oh, yeah, go into the priest hole. Yeah, that's a good idea.
There's a window with red light coming. Oh, no. She doesn't care about that. She's walking down the hallway. Oh, there's a noise. She turns around.
Oh, my gosh.
She's not scared. No. She's just... There's noises. What's going on? It sounded like a very sinister laugh. Walking down a super, super creepy hallway.
Yeah,
she says, how did you get in there, you silly dog?
That's
opens
no
the door.
Dog. That's
guess
no dog.
What? The dog.
That's no dog.
Not. And the dog is on the other end of the hallway barking at her.
That dog is just a
and
rat.
And she's like, holy, oh my gosh.
What?
So she opened the door a bit. She's like, holy frick, what's on the other side of the door? The camera panned out and the crimson... creepy witch was there. It was just like, and then like went inside.
Oh, she found the mason jars. That's where I left those.
That's where the peanut butter is. I've been out.
The peanut butter.
Yeah, the peanut butter.
Yeah, that dog's just about to get just sushi shanked.
And the door closes on its own. Oh my gosh! And the crimson chick is crawling out of the floor towards her. Oh, dog's like, peace. Holy frick. Creepy arse things just like. Oh my
gosh. Oh yeah,
gosh.
She's not allowed to go down there, remember?
So she runs into the elevator and she's going down to the bottom level to escape that thing that was just dragging itself on the floor towards her. Creepy as sin. Now she's at the bottom level.
A few spider webs, but otherwise good condition. Dog is fearless though.
Dog is just knows what it's doing.
At this point, we do know that the dog is the smarter between these two.
Yeah, it looks like there's these vaults. You still hear the creepy lady from upstairs. She throws on the lights down there and looks like there's all these.
Have you ever thought about how it's nighttime for her, but yet the lighting outside is immaculate?
Yeah. Yeah.
But.
Ew!
What?
There's goopy stuff coming out of the thing.
Dude, it's the mud, remember?
Oh, yeah. Okay, so she found...
Enola.
Oh. All right, so now we're outside... Loki's looking at his machine, which he does have a big version of it, which Papa at the beginning gave him hack over. And he's all about clay. It's clay.
It's
clay.
From PEI, apparently.
Oh. Oh, she's tried to ask him about violent deaths that have ever happened, and he doesn't really want to answer. Oh, he was trying to fix something on the machine, and there was steam, and it burnt him.
Yeah.
Now Alice is fixing
him
up.
Position,
so here's what happens.
Okay, yeah, tell me. Tell me what happens, Guillermo.
Here's what happens.
Shoot. Did you just see that behind her?
No, what was it?
It was just the window. It looks like a nice day outside.
Oh, no.
Sorry, you were saying?
So they live for forever, him and his sister, mm-hmm. but they need
a sacrifice every so often. So they go from town to town to town to try to find the perfect innocent soul.
Well, I will say this then. For a ghost, he's incredibly well-traveled.
He's not a ghost, he's a vampire.
Oh, he's a vamp.
Yeah. If he is a vampire, I'm going to be a little...
What did you say?
A little bummed out.
Crimson Peak. That's what they call it. The ore and the red clay leads up from the ground and stains snow.
Oh.
So, Crimson Peak.
The ore in the clay that makes it super red is called Crimson Peak, and now she... Why is she crying?
She's crying because she realizes how dumb she is, that she's got a mansion at her feet on a massive hill with red clay.
Okay, okay.
And
yeah,
she didn't figure out that they might have called this place Crimson Peak. Sweetheart, this is Rouge Hill.
Now that you have mentioned that, Keith, I'm getting a little emotional too.
Like, she's an idiot.
Oh. All right, Chuck, we're back at the place. Chuck's talking to probably the new CEO in place of Papa. At the cemetery.
Great place for business meetings.
He's telling CEO that the last check... Give him pause.
I wonder what kind of pause.
All right. Okay, I gotta say this really
that
quick.
Pause.
So, Chuck... is now super suspicious. Oh, frick.
What?
Okay, so Alice is having a dream. She's outside in a cornfield. There's a crimson, creepy chick hovering over the cornfield.
Dude.
Harvested cornfield, pointing at something. Oh, frick!
What?
Alice wakes up. She's coughing, and she's coughing up blood.
She's peeking crimson right now.
She's got the tuberculosis. Is that tuberculosis when you cough blood?
It could be something
like that.
Bronchitis.
I got a shot for it, so I'm good.
UTI.
I won't
need it. That'll do it. You have a nosebleed. Oh, it must be a UTI.
Don't women usually once a month cough up blood?
Are you here with me? Give me a signal.
Give me a signal?
That's what she just said.
All right. She's all creeped out. She has her hand out. She's like, if you're here with me, give me a signal. Holy freaking mothers. So a shadow just walked across the window in the room with her. She's creeped out, but she wants a sign. Or a signal, as Keith would say.
Oh, yeah. She's got terrible Wi-Fi in there.
Something invisible grabbed her arm and yanked her hand
down
to the
floor.
Meanwhile,
the dog is just... Yeah, this is par for the course in this creepy house.
Oh, she's... Oh, frick! What? She's hearing something dung fricked up from the bathroom.
I can't for the life of me understand why this woman keeps going to every dark
No,
corner.
Keith, she needs to know. So she's moving towards... Doesn't. All we are is looking at her from the room in which she's going towards. We can't see what's happening in there, but we're going to, and it's not going to be pretty.
Well, she needs some vitamin D.
She peers in. She opens the doors. She's walking through. She doesn't look
very... And
she
finds the Philosopher's Stone.
No philosophers. All right, she's going in the bathroom.
Yeah, she's in the tub.
Looks like something's in the tub. Something's in the tub. A ghost is in the tub.
Yeah, let her be.
We can see that there's ghostly exoplasm coming off the ghost.
Ectoplasm?
Nope. And then there's it's in the tub all ghostly.
Oh, with a knife in her head.
Cleaver in its head. All right, it's getting up. It's doing the ghost noises. It's standing up in the tub. Alice is freaking out.
Oh, it's her. Oh, my gosh. That's Jessica Chastain.
Now. Thomas!
Oh, frick. Now it's in the hallway walking towards her. I have to say, this ghost needs to put some clothes on. His blood. Oh, frick. It has eyes now. She said, its blood will be on you. His blood will be on you. She runs to Thomas. She says, there is something there. He looks down the hallway. Nothing's there. Now Alice is in hysterics telling Loki and Jessica. Jessica's making her tea. They don't believe her.
You were sleepwalking.
Sleepwalking, you were. You right foul
sleep,
old git.
Sleepwalking, you right foul git. What are you, a Nance?
You Nancy.
She says she had to leave.
This is your home now.
Jessica says this is your home.
You have nowhere else to go.
Drink your tea. Oh, Loki didn't like that she said that.
Wow, she's just... I'm sorry, this actress is just the equivalent of Captain Crunch cereal. It seems sweet, but she's just cutting the roof of my mouth.
It seems sweet and savory, but you're disappointed on the first bite.
It's kind of like pork.
Oh, what about pulled pork with some great barbecue sauce and hot toss?
Maybe. Do you want to eat that?
Yes. I would go for a pulled pork sandwich.
Oh, I think she just said something.
All right, people are talking.
Yeah, probably not.
Really rude that they're interrupting us.
Yeah, that's a little rude, eh? We're trying to do a podcast. And
we are trying
acting.
To have a conversation, and they just keep talking.
I think I just burped up a yesterday. Yikes.
All right, Loki's traveling somewhere. He's looking at stuff in a box. Alice is there. Oh, it must be tools for
his thingy.
For his thingy. Tools for his thingy.
For his crimson peak.
Ew! Oh, that was rude. All right, she's got mail.
Bing! You have mail.
From someone in Italy. Oh, look. Jake Nicole.
Oh, gosh. Did you... Rio!
If anyone knows who Jake Nicole is, shout out to Jake Nicole.
Great guy, good drummer.
180 drums.
Great guy, good drummer. Good guy, great drummer.
Look, kind of looks like Conan.
Yeah, Johnny Bravo.
Okay. Oh, yeah, totally. All right. Chuck is talking to the dad's informant. Showing him showing Chuck a newspaper clipping.
He's like, something great is happening.
It's weird watching two British actors. I know Bern Gorman. I know he's British. Charlie Hunnam. I think he's South African or something.
Oh.
But it's weird watching two guys whose native tongue isn't like American English or Canadian English trying to speak it. Because I bet to them they're putting on the same kind of accent that you and I would like. Yeah, you just ride on your.
Oh, right. I will get there, Malfoy.
I love the English breakfast tea.
I hear you. I see you. I hear you. Mm. But what we just missed was that
they went to a log cabin.
Chuck found out that Loki here, the reason why her father was so against them getting married. Mm. Guess what? Loki's already married.
Oh, that's fine though. He's married to his sister. We know that they kissed.
Oh, Luke and Leia, bit gross. Game of Thrones, bit gross. She says, let's live somewhere else. Loki's like, I can't because I have to kill you in this house.
Yeah, he should just offer right now. Start over again, buddy. Plenty
She's in the perfect position to slice that throat.
Wow. That was aggressive.
Sorry. Yes, I have once. Have you ever been to Italy? He said, yes, I have once.
And that's where we got married to.
Thomas, quit looking in the past, she says.
She's here. I'm here
too. No, you're not. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to be in Asgard.
No, he is there. Oh, they kissy kissy?
Ew.
Is it going to turn into the hokey pokey? The hokey what pokey. The frick? Strangely accurate.
And you're shaking it all about. That's what it's all about.
Oh, boy. They're getting ready for the hokey pokey.
I would say so.
I would say, children, look away. Oh, boy, there's groaning and movements. But no ho... Oh! Oh, boy.
Alfie, excuse me, I'm going to eat your kneecap.
Yeah, he's Tom. Chewing on our kneecap.
Tom.
Oh, Loki, you behave. All right, we're kissing again. It's all good. Oh, my.
You.
Oh, okay. So, Keith.
Whoa.
I would say there's probably nothing better in this world than a nice big panzerotti.
You.
Am I right?
That's gross.
All right. Just so everyone knows.
Is that the first time that they consummated their marriage?
Yeah, the first time they did the hokey pokey.
Well, that's kind of, well, good for them. I guess they did wait.
Yeah, they waited a long time. Good for you, even though they were married. They still waited. I think you should never have hokey pokey.
No.
Even when you're married.
Well.
Because that is satanic.
I would say, you know what? You wait till marriage. In their case, they waited like 3 weeks after marriage.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They waited. They didn't wait long enough.
Lucille?
All right, so... someone's gone. They left the stove on. Something on the stove on the stove. Ooh. Jessica Chastain comes in. She done look done, no happy.
Of course not. She's been wearing the same thing. She probably stinks.
That was... Oh, I'll tell you. Oh, this is so good.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't. It'll take too long.
Kind of like this movie's plot development?
Yeah.
You slept there. What's wrong with that, Lucille? He's my husband.
Oh!
This is all a game to you. It's frantic. What are you talking about?
You too. Whoa, what? Okay. Jessica just found out that they did the hokey pokey and she freaked out. She spilled all of the food all over the table. She was going to hit her with the frying pan. What the frick? She just freaks out at Alice. Oh, she left the keys.
Yeah, she's
she
fine.
Freaked out on Alice for sleeping with him, doing the hanky-panky. And then she's like, I don't feel well. And she's like, I'll go make you some tea. Oh, Alice is removing one of the keys that says...
Enola.
Enola. Like granola.
Or the old bomb, the Enola Gay, the bomber?
No.
Oh.
No, don't know anything about that.
Yeah. When you see this one on, when you see that on the Remax Realty website, that's a house to you that says, yeah, there's nothing wrong with that house.
Yeah, there's a massive hole in it. All right, she's not reading letters. She's got her
Harry Potter glasses on.
Oh my gosh.
Are you kidding me, man?
Oh, we have another 45 minutes left in this.
Like, we literally... Okay, so we just checked out the time on this, and we've got 45 minutes left. And if you know anything about my attention span...
I have the attention span of a goldfish. I love the Blue Jays.
Oh.
Goldfish?
Oh, sorry, I moved on to something else.
I recently saw a fish the other day.
Did you? Did you catch it?
No, but there's computers in a store, and I looked at them.
Oh...
It rained.
So what she's doing right now is she's going downstairs into the basement. She's going to take a look open at this tickle trunk and find out what's inside.
She's
going
to take a look and open it.
Again, this woman's just an idiot.
I think she's very smart, Keith.
I think she's pretty
dumb. She made the casting. She puts the key in, she turns it, and it goes to Loki flipping a switch on his machine with wing dingles and hang bangers. Figgly bits.
Bangers and mash.
Oh! There's footprints.
But that's just the dirt, man. That's totally fine.
No, did you see it was
you
seeping
keep
through?
Freaking out.
Seeping through. Seeping through. Oh it was seeping gosh, through. Dude. All right. She opened up the case. There's a...
A lunchbox. So that's probably
a lunchbox.
Stale.
There's some letters. Oh, there's a voice.
Milan,
Oh, it was a throwback to her father saying you tried to do stuff in all these places, and it happened to be the places with envelopes.
So let's find out what's now in the
cages. Now, one of the vats are shaking.
Oh, it's they're like cages.
I bet someone's going to... Oh! She cracked it open with a thing, and she's looking inside. It's all red paste. Something's going to come out of that. Oh,
bud, this is the ketchup factory.
Yeah. This is it. Crimson Peak, formerly known as Heinz. She's putting a stick in the goopy goop.
Yeah, wouldn't you?
Until she couldn't put it down. Got some
tomato soup going by.
Yeah, now she's kind of stirring it. See if she can find anything.
And what does she find? A ghost.
Yeah, a ghost is definitely going to come out of there.
Red is a very interesting color, though, isn't it?
James Wan loves the color red. Oh, it's starting to bubble. Something's coming out.
Oh, yeah, it's that ghost. The creepy one with no head.
Oh, it's slowly coming out of the goopy goop. Oh, yeah, because it's missing a finger.
Yeah.
Isn't it beautiful?
All right. Goes back to Loki. He's very happy about his machine. He says, hey, Jessica, we did it.
I did this with you.
Yes, of course you did. Yeah. We did this together.
They dig it together. They need more coal. Oh. He needs a key. She's looking at the keys and realizes one is missing.
Yeah, and another reason why this woman is really stupid is that she just opened a vat of clearly someone else's property, decided not to put it back.
Jessica's running into the house. Where's Edith? Edith has the envelopes and the key and the box that were inside the chest. Jessica's coming up the stairs. Alice runs into the room. Jessica's looking around, can't find her. Edith hides the stuff under the chair, sits down on the chair, and she pretends she was sleeping just as Jessica came in. Jessica's looking around the room.
I want to apologize for my behavior this morning. I was concerned that you didn't drink your tea.
I don't feel so well.
Would you mind bringing me some coffee?
Ooh, Alice asked for cold water.
Of course.
And laid the keys down on the table and then walked out.
Well, she's going to put it back, now she knows. And
ooh, she got water from the bathroom. Ew. Sits back down, puts her hand to her head. Jessica walks back in.
I should let you rest.
Yeah, you should.
You'll feel better soon.
Oh, Jessica was touching her head and saying, you'll feel better soon. Jessica's leaving and she's counting the keys. She slows down. There's the key.
So here's what we know about Jessica Chastain's.
She's a redhead who changed her hair color, and that is the worst part of this whole movie. Am I right?
I think at this point, I'd say you're going a little overboard. I mean, I don't want to say you're like...
I'm not off, though.
No. Oh, she opened the lunchbox, and she found in it...
Oh, it's like a xylophone or Enneagram.
A smartphone.
There, she found a smartphone.
That...
It's a phonograph.
Gramophone.
Grandma's phone. She's listening to what's on it. 1887. She's talking about Thomas. Who's Loki?
Oh, but remember the latent images in the background?
Oh! Yeah. There's a picture of her, this, of a person in a wheelchair, which is probably this girl. And then there are super old pictures of Loki and Jessica. She opens the other package, even more old pictures of Loki and Jessica. Land certificate.
Dude, this is what I'm telling you. They're brother and sister, but they're married. It's creeps.
No, they're vampires.
They're not vampires.
They're vampires.
Vampires don't have feelings.
Yeah, they do. Have you ever seen Edward Cullen? He has feelings.
He has feelings. I'll give you that. Team Jacob, though.
Team Jake? No. Are you serious?
Not big time. Oh, gross. I think I actually feel like I'm burping up things that I like in July.
Keith, I am super upset, and we may have to turn this movie off right now.
Why?
Team Jacob.
Yeah, big time.
Are you... No.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Dude.
He's a hunk.
There's the dog in a picture from 300 years ago. Team Edward. Frick Jacob.
Team Jedward. Oh, there's the baby.
Team Jebediah.
There's the baby.
Oh, the poison's in the tea. So Jessica's been poisoning her with the tea. Oh, she ran right through the snow. That would have been cold on the feet.
Yeah, I would think so.
She's trying to leave. She opens a door. Oh, it's a snowstorm out
there.
This
is... Yeah, this was where I wanted to be tonight. I'm going to run out.
There's snow drifts that are taller than her out there. Close the door!
Jonas, can
you... You're letting in a draft!
Yep. Can you please, like, agree with me that this woman's not smart?
No, I definitely would say she's not the sharpest tool in the shed.
I don't even think she's even on the property.
Hard cut. She is now in bed and she's looking sickly, Keith.
Oh, I mean, she's pale.
No, but she has dark circles around her eyes now. Oh, Jessica. She's at the end of her bed. You're awake. I found you at the bottom of the stairs. You feel better? She needs to see a doctor.
Don't yes, worry, because the doctor's on his way to see you.
There's tea. She doesn't want the tea. Keith!
I'm spitting mud right now, boys.
Keith, if I smell that...
I hope you do. That's a homebrew I've been building as a craft brew for some time.
No!
That is pungent. That is an air biscuit.
An ear biscuit? Rhett and Link's podcast, Ear Biscuits? Everyone go ahead and check out Ear Biscuits by Rhett and Link.
Okay, mine was an air biscuit, but okay.
We should have a podcast called Air Biscuits. That's what we should have called this. Alright, so Jessica now has mutt.
What?
Oh, I can't deal with...
Oh, you don't like the
scraping, like, scraping yeah. plates.
Oh, you're going to need to man up.
I can't, man. I'll leave the room. Oh! No, I can't do that. Okay, so Jessica's feeding her, like, mush from a teacup.
Oh, it's the dog!
I'm gonna put this down, Keith. Because if she scrapes one more time, I'm out.
Dude.
I'm dead serious.
No, she's fine.
Alright, she put down
yeah, she's
the...
Fine. See?
She has a cup of tea.
You want a cup of tea?
Alice, I
said drink
your
tea.
Oh, Loki came in and saved her. I want to be alone with my wife.
Yeah, get that out of you.
That was
boiling deep inside.
I get scared sometimes.
Get a little gassy.
Big gassy. All right, guess. Oh, the wheelchair. Loki comes in with the wheelchair. Guess what? She's going to need a wheelchair because everyone needs a wheelchair because they slowly poison them.
And if you want to keep it to yourself, that's okay because wheelchair.
You want to talk about it? No, because it's natural business.
Oh.
Right?
Pesos. His name is Pedro.
All right, so here's the thing. Loki's actually falling in love with her.
What,
he
his
doesn't
sister?
Want... No. Alice, he doesn't want Alice to die.
Yeah, but he's gonna have to anyway.
Oh! She says you're stopping her from drinking the tea. The poison's still in the porridge.
Stop it! Do we have to do this? Must we?
See? Told you.
Just chill. Yes.
Sorry.
You have no idea what they do.
taken from here. Locked away. You would be hanged.
Hanged? She says, you couldn't leave me. She touches his face. He pulls away. He says, I can't. Or he maybe said another word that we cannot say on this podcast.
Oh! Yeah.
He keeps saying that word. All right, they're both crying. She kisses his eye, which was weird.
Well, it's moist.
Keith, this is the longest movie ever, and... This hour? I can't believe we don't have the power.
Can I hire one from you?
It's Chuck.
I'm gonna get there on foot.
It's well over 4 hours following the road.
Then I better get going.
Alright, Chuck is looking for the house. Chuck's gonna try to save her. Oh!
Crimson's peeking.
Alice is just in the bathroom, just like coughing up blood everywhere.
I haven't seen a ghost in a while.
Sits back on the chair. She's rolling around. Easy there, wheels.
easy there, shoes.
Easy there. Oh, she heard a freaky deaky from behind her. Guess what? It's hard to run away in a wheelchair.
Wow, so the only like skill that this woman has possessed like positively at this point?
Oh. There's Crimson Lady
hovering in the middle of the entrance
with a crimson baby.
With the baby.
Your name is Enola Shadi.
Alice recognizes her. What do you want from me? Crimson Lady points upstairs.
What do I want from you? I want you to pull my finger.
Yeah, pull my finger, see what happens.
A ghostly, ghastly fart erupts.
All right. Dude, I'm seeing things. I'm wigging out in your house right now.
Yeah, you're not doing too well.
No.
Pull your pants back on.
No, I'm actually very comfortable like this, thank you.
Well, that's something.
Just so everyone knows, I am wearing pants. All right. Alice goes to where the lady's pointing in the hallway full of moths. She opens the door. She walks in. It's well lit. She hears singing. Allison looks scared and confused.
Because she sees, I bet, a family member.
She's seeing someone get murdered. Oh. She sees, is that Loki and Jessica?
Yeah, big time.
Oh! Her hand is down his pants.
Dude, this is weird.
Loki looks up. He sees her. She's freaked out. She's crying. It is Jessica. She's stumbling down the hallway, unconsolable. She calls the elevator.
It's all out in the open now.
Jessica's coming after her.
This is who I am. This is who he is. And you.
Oh.
I am.
She pushed her over the... Oh! Jessica pushed her over the railing. She fell, hit one of the railings on the balcony below.
Took a little bit of a tumble off the cliff, did we?
And then fell in a pile of snow on the main floor, which cushioned her fall. Someone is at the door. Jessica ripped the finger off of Alice's hand before she pushed her and put the ring on.
Yeah, but fade then you to saw black. The...
That's it. Movie's done.
But then you saw some of the dirt coming through. Oh,
thank the prophets it's done. All right, just kidding. All right, Alice wakes up and Chuck is there. You know, he looks like Pete Holmes.
Who's Pete Holmes?
He's a comedian.
I don't know what Pete Holmes.
Oh, he's a great dude.
Yeah?
Super great. He has a podcast. You made it weird.
Pete Holmesy?
Pete Holmes.
Oh, Peter.
Forgive me for dropping in.
You know him as Pete. But Peter, yeah.
Okay.
I found his career quite petered out, if you know what I mean.
I thought you'd enjoy the surprise.
It's a miracle. Pretty not to do. She's so ill.
Oh, they're talking to Chuck.
Who spoke to me? Who spoke to you?
She said they spoke to me. My mother spoke to me. She was delivering a warning. Crimson Peak.
Clarice, you see poor thing.
Yes, I see.
Oh, he's going to drink the tea? No, he's going to give the tea to Alice.
Yeah, he has to.
She won't accept the tea. Jessica says, you'll stay here with us, won't you, Chuck? He says, if you insist. She's going to kill him. Alright, he says he needs a moment alone with Alice. So Jessica... and whatever. Chuck says, Alice, I'm here to take you away. I'm taking you with me now. Oh, Jessica goes into a drawer. She gets a knife and says,
"You this time." So yeah, you know what that means.
They've been doing this for a while. Because they're vampires.
They're not vampires.
Keith, what else?
He was out in the sunlight.
That doesn't matter. There's different kinds of vampires.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Edward Cullens, they shine when they're in sunlight.
They sparkle, do they, yes?
Sparkles.
Sparkle.
Oh, he's carrying her to the door, and they are right behind him.
She's exhausted.
She's
showing signs of anemia. I'm going to take her to a hospital.
That won't be necessary.
There's a standoff. He says he needs to take her, and they're not willing to let her go.
I wonder why.
You've been poisoning her. He called it.
Front page. Front blood ledger. Beatrice Sharp was murdered in the bathtub.
Oh, frick. He hands her a old newspaper clipping.
Split her head in two. That
and
sense.
The drawing is of a woman in a bathtub with a knife in her head.
Sir Thomas, you were only 12 at the time. After questioning by the police, you were sent to boarding school. As for Lucille, at 14, her story is less clear. The convent education in Switzerland, the news account says, but I think a different kind of institution.
Okay. So, Loki was 12 when it happened. She was 14. Look at the red stuff coming down the walls.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yes, you don't know. Yes, and I are leaving.
Dude, are you okay? Are you actually legitimately crying?
I'm a little tearful. Oh, frick! Ew!
That's it?
Jessica whipped out a knife, stabbed him in the armpit, something proper.
Yeah.
That is not a place I would want a knife. He stumbles back. He looks. The knife in his armpit.
Oh, the dog's come out to play.
Oh, he pulls the knife out and blood squirts everywhere. He's trying to leave. Jessica tries to leave too. Or Alice tries to leave too. Jessica throws her back on her chair. Loki walks up to him. Loki has... Oh!
If I don't do it,
what?
Jessica just killed the dog.
Oh, that's fine. Because they've had to kill the dog before, remember?
You're a doctor. Show me where.
Show him where? How to kill him quickly?
No. How to, like, pretend to kill him.
All right, so look, that's what he said?
Yeah, because he said, show me where, you're a doctor.
And so where to kill him, like, quickly, or...
No, show me where to stab you so that you don't die. That's what I think.
Well, anyway, no, I think he's done dead.
Nah.
So Loki's like, where should I stab you? And then Chuck moved the knife to a spot on his lower abdomen. Ooh, Loki stabbed him. And oh yeah,
so now he'll throw him in one of the vats.
Oh, where can I stab you in a place where you will probably live then?
The moment he signs those papers, he's dead. I have to go.
Loki's trying to help him.
I'll find a way.
Because Loki wants Alice to live.
That's what I'm saying.
Jessica's the fricked up one.
Oh, yeah. Well, she was making it with her brother and giving him the handy. So
Chuck is alive. Loki brought him down to the basement. Oh, but he's bleeding good. He's bleeding good and proper.
Right proper. Right
proper. And the right proper bleeder, yeah.
Oh, he's a crimson peeking right out of his abs, he is. Who's this girl?
That's Jessica.
Oh. Hey, Jess.
Yo, what's up, Jessie girl?
How you doing with that hair, Rapunzel?
Oh, that's a good call. She does look like a Rapunzel.
Yeah, she's
looks a little bit tangled.
Oh,
Keith, what a freaking boring movie.
Yeah, this is just terrible. I haven't seen a ghost in a while. How much time is left?
I'm going to say 20 minutes.
Oh, wow. You're pretty well brang on.
Yeah.
Brang on?
Jessica walks over to Alice with a pair of scissors and starts touching her hair.
And says, have you seen the movie Edward Scissorhands?
Have you seen the movie Alice in Wonderland? Because I star in it!
And I thought you were terrible inside of it.
Don't you
understand? It was mine. Oh! Jessica cut off a huge lock of Alice's hair.
We didn't.
I wanted it. She told me she could save it.
What?
She was determined.
Was she going to braid the hair?
Oh, this horror. Yeah, wouldn't you?
What?
Yeah, so...
Wait for it.
Jessica is now braiding.
Wait for it.
The marriages were for money, of course. The horror.
The crimson horror.
Mad, full of sweat and regret.
Ooh, yikes.
This love burns you and maims you.
And the word that she's looking for is that love is called incest, and it is incredibly illegal.
Unless you're in Game of Thrones. Well, it's still illegal in Game of Thrones?
I'm pretty sure it's still illegal.
Keith, I cannot get over how close that microphone is to your mouth.
That's all right. They love it.
I have to say, there are times I listen back and I can hear you breathing for quite a while.
Good. I want people to know that when they're friends with me, this is what they get. They get a cheesy mouth breather who's close to your face and all up in your personal bubble.
And he, oh, frick, she opens a drawer and there's
donuts.
Four other hair braids.
There's donuts.
Precious. She closes the door. Alice definitely didn't see it.
That woman is just Alice so sickly knows. Pale.
Yeah, she's gross.
That's not true. You suffocate him. Sign
your
name. Oh. Sign your bloody name.
She's signing her name. I did.
Of course. Condescending man. He loved you.
He did.
Should have seen his sad face. And I smashed it on the sink.
Oh, Jessica is the one who killed her father.
We kind of assumed that, though, didn't we?
Oh! Oh, friggin'. Alice just jumped Jessica and stuck the pen in her chest.
All right, folks. So we are happy right now because now something is legitimately happening in the movie.
Yeah, we got some anger happening. Alice is having a hard time with life. Okay, she calls the elevator. Loki comes up. She's threatening him. Loki's trying to convince her that he's good.
I do.
He said, believe me or not.
He's saying he's going to finish it because you walked in on him with his sister before.
He says, I'm going to get those papers. He grabs the papers and he's throwing them in the fire. Oh, he hears someone's voice. He turns around.
It's Jessica.
It looks like Jessica is Chastain.
She
with
said
blood.
You burned the papers. He said you won't touch her.
Think about it. We can start a new life.
Where?
Anywhere. It doesn't matter. We can leave it behind. We let the sharp men die with the mines. We let this edifice sink in the ground. All these years holding these walls together, we would be free.
What's up?
Do you have next door neighbor dogs?
Nope. There's a ghost. No dogs.
Because I heard dogs barking.
We've been dead for years. We see
how
you and I in this rotting place.
You've loved me more than me.
Look at what we've become.
You promised you would not fall in love with anyone else.
Yes, but it happened.
Oh, he fell in love. Jessica is crushed. Oh! She stabs
These are
him.
The most undramatic strabbings? Strabbing.
Oh! She just stabbed
wow.
him right in the face.
Yeah, he's not doing well right now.
And he's like, oh, his eyes all bloodshot. He's like his cheekbone. And he's pulling
That's disgusting.
The knife out.
That is disgusting.
Oh! Ew, his eyes all fricked.
Dude, this is disgusting.
This is, like, weird. Oh, and crying blood. Oh, frick, she killed him. Jessica's freaking out.
You know, you hear it
Loki's
quite
dead.
You hear it quite often, but getting the idea of getting stabbed in the face, like, when you actually have a full frontal of that, that is not attractive.
I have to say, that knife went into his face. She stabbed him very slowly, but it went in like butter.
Oh, yeah, he's got the complexion
he's
of porcelain.
Very, yeah, very nice. Okay, so now Alice is calling out for Thomas in the moth hallway.
Oh, we're going to see some ghosts.
And, oh, frick, there's Jessica with the knife running after her, screaming. Alice jumps in the elevator, closes the door, and pulls the switch, and it's heading downstairs. Jessica's running like a crazy woman down the stairs, red stuff pouring down the walls.
Do you think do you think the ghosts are going to be on her side now?
I think so. Alice stopped off at the kitchen. She's looking for something. He found a big old nasty knife. Just as she found... Oh! No.
It's disgusting.
Okay, so Alice is in the elevator. Jessica's trying to get in. Jessica's hand was preventing the elevator door from closing while she swung at Alice with a knife in the other hand. So Alice just starts slicing her hand and then crushing her hand in the door. Finally, Jessica lets go. Alice goes downstairs. Jessica's now running down the stairs. She goes up to Chuck, who's bleeding everywhere.
Oh, hello. How are you?
Puts down the knife, grabs him, and says she's coming. We have to get out of here.
Yeah, there's an understatement. Let's get out of the creepy house.
She left the knife, though.
And what looked like an iPhone charger.
Yep, she left. She is not charged. She should be charging her phone, but she's not. Jessica comes down the stairs. She sees all the vats.
And the stairway to heaven.
She's trying to find out where they are. But guess what?
There's a ghost.
There's no ghost. But Alice isn't going to let her know. Oh, Jessica's moving a stone.
Oh, she found a gun.
She pulled something out from the floor. Alice looks up and reveals a old nasty.
Remember that was
knife.
The knife that was in the other ghost's head.
Yeah.
Oh. She kept it for. Oh, that's cute.
So the chick who died in the bathtub is mother. All right. Alice reaches over and grabs the knife. Now she's ready to face
Dude,
off
Jessica. I think we're going to see a ghost be on her side.
Yeah. Oh! Jessica hissed at her and scared me. All right, they're standing off. Jessica looks like she has a little more gusto to take control. Alice starts running. She's climbing up the shaft that goes outside. She's outside in the snow.
Mm-hmm.
The ground is all red from the clay. She jumps and hurts herself. She's cold, though.
Wouldn't you?
It's really hard to see her in the blizzard with her complexion. All right, she's hiding behind the machine. Jessica jumps out of the hole. She's looking
around.
Turn on the machine.
Do a kickflip.
What are you waiting on? Just turn on the machine.
All right, Alice goes around to attack her, and Jessica's gone.
Wouldn't you be gone, too? It's cold.
I would probably want to have myself... I bet they aren't even wearing Skechers. A nice big cup of hot cocoa. All right, Alice has the knife pointing in all directions. She doesn't know where Jessica is. Joe! She puts her back to the machine. Whoa. Jessica appeared, slashed at her, and then disappeared. All right, the machine has now been turned on. Thank you, Keith.
You're welcome. I come up with good ideas in horror movies when it comes to dumb idiots.
Alice is looking around, can't see her. Machine's running, she's backing up. Oh, frick. She came out of nowhere. No. Jessica grabs the blade.
Oh. That's nice though, right?
She grabs the blade and blood was coming from her hand. Rips the knife out of Alice's hand. Whoa.
Yikes.
Alice picks up a shovel to defend herself.
Wouldn't you?
They're exchanging words. Help me.
There's no one here to help you. Yes, there is. Look at him. Turn around.
Look at him. Turn around, she says to Jessica. What? Jessica's going to freaking throw herself in the machine. Jessica turns around. And
is
there
that
he
her
is.
Dad?
No, it's Loki as a ghost. Wow, he's a good-looking ghost.
He's a good-looking ghost.
Alice raises the shovel and hits Jessica square in the face. Jessica's down, grabs the knife again.
So I think she dies and then they become ghost lovers and friends.
Oh, hits her really hard on the top of the head.
You know, for someone who's gotten poisoned,
looked
she's oddly spry.
Like her head caved in a bit. She looks up. Alice looks up. Who is she looking at? Loki? Yeah, she goes over to Loki, who has exoplasm coming out of the knife hole in his face. He's all white and creepy. Kind of looks like Marilyn Manson. She can touch him, though.
Yeah, wouldn't you?
She touches him. But it's all ghostly. There's a bit of ghost vapor
blood
left on her fingers. She's looking at it. And
bye-bye.
Loki disappears.
Into the machine, it would seem.
Yeah.
Where'd Pacific Rim go? He's still kicking around somewhere, isn't he?
Oh, he's done dead.
Nah, he's good. He's chill.
He's chill.
Oh, maybe he's in the spa at the bottom there.
Ghosts or what?
This much right now.
All right. Now, a big aerial shot of Alice and what's his butthole?
Pacific Rim.
Chuck
and Bo.
Leaving the property, and there's a bunch of townspeople waiting for them.
Something tells me that was the climax.
She looks back.
That house better get destroyed and sink into the ground.
And the camera's going into the house. There's blood at the entrance of the house. Camera's floating through the house. It's going up. Looks at the broken banister that Alice hit when she fell, when Jessica pushed her. Goes towards a roaring fireplace. Fireplace all of a sudden dies down.
Oh, they've got natural gas and that's pretty chill. There she
There's
can play
ghost
her piano.
Jessica playing the piano. I don't know how she's doing it, but she is playing the piano. Ooh, Jessica's not looking so good, though. She definitely is dead.
She had a rough day, eh?
She did.
She did.
And that's it. Directed by Guillermo del Toro.
All right.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Written by Guillermo del Toro and Matthew Robbins. So the movie's done.
Oh, man, that sucked.
I'm not going to drag this out any longer.
That sucked.
Movie's done.
I'm going to give a quick little rating on it, though, because that's going to be the most funny part of the whole darn thing.
For sure. Hold on.
On a scale of number one to number two?
On a scale of two, it was definitely a two.
Oh, my God. This was worse than a two. First of all, it looked pretty. This was the cinematic equivalent of that, like, really well-meaning and intentioned, but just insufferable Italian girl that you dated in high school.
Oh, boy. Can I,
Look pretty, but just hideous.
Yeah, just,
worst personality.
Mouthful of wooden teeth.
Well, I do like a wood teeth. Well, it's like they say, if you ain't Dutch, you ain't much. That's what I always say. Some would say. I would say.
Bit rude.
A little bit.
Okay, so let me just say this. In regards to horror commentary,
yeah.
Terrible movie.
It was not a horror movie.
That
wasn't a horror
movie. It had three scary scenes in a two-hour movie. For one, movie was way too long. I was talking too much because I wanted to be scared. I was descriptive videoing. I don't know the story at all. Other than, oops, stuff happened.
Yeah, so I'll fill you in on the story.
Well, no.
Some stuff happened.
Okay.
A ghost was there, looked creepy.
Okay.
Tom Hiddleston is hella fly.
He a fine AF.
He is fine. He is smart. He is important. And then there's a pale girl who's just dumb the whole time.
Yeah. So I think if I had gone into this movie, like maybe watch... My wife and I, we were going to watch this a couple months ago.
Oh, you should have.
And I think that would have been the right setting to watch it. But... In terms of horror, horribly disappointed.
I would have preferred something with Morgan Freeman.
And it's funny because I messaged Keith and I was... Because we were like, oh, what movie are we going to watch? And I was like, hey, Crimson Peak, directed by Guillermo del Toro. Need I go on? It's going to be amazing. Yeah. But I have to say...
This sullied his name a little bit.
It was a gothic drama.
I'm going to need to wait for Pacific Rim 2 to come out just for him to redeem his... directorial and filming abilities.
Okay. Are you sure he's directing it?
Well, I don't know. I don't know these things.
Okay, I don't think he is. I thought I heard somewhere that he wasn't.
I hope Queen Latifah plays one of the robots. I'm pretty sure
she's going to direct it.
The Queen Latifah in Pacific Rim. I think that's all for me, man. I am just shot.
Yeah, I feel like that movie took a piece of my soul away. Super disappointing. I wouldn't even rate it. I thought it was pretty bad. I mean, for one, I think Jessica Chastain was the wrong choice for that role. She did not fit that role.
No, she didn't.
And it's not because she's a redhead.
A little bit to do with the redhead, though.
To me, the role didn't seem to fit her. She wasn't a good choice for casting.
Great at stabbing people, though, I must say.
Oh, she's got right through the face like butter and cheese.
Very stabby.
Tom Hiddleston was amazing, I guess. I don't really know. I don't know. I was pretty bummed by the whole thing.
Well, like,
it has a 6.6 out of 10 on IMDb, but I wouldn't even give it that. I'd probably give it a solid 3.
I gave it an I out of an IMDb.
So. Sure. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to leave this one here. Thanks so much for listening. Don't forget to tip your waitress. And hopefully next time we'll have a better horror movie for you.
Coming up after Crimson Peak,
Red Mountain.
That's all I got. Okay. Have a good night, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Thank you for listening to Horror Commentary. Follow us on Twitter at JK Horror Podcast, on Facebook at facebook.com/horrorcommentary, or email us at horrorcommentarypodcast@gmail.com. Also jump over to iTunes and give us a big 5 stars. I'm Chad. See you next time. Bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.